Hey guys, this is Zach with 8020 Media here today with a guide and details about N54 single turbo versus twin turbo upgrades. So part of the reason we're filming this now, it might be a little while before we actually have much content and some kind of more in-depth comparisons and videos about single turbo and twin turbo N54s. We have a bit of a different setup in the garage right now because Jake's 135 is up on the lift behind me here. We're going to do a little basic maintenance to it. And when we started taking stuff apart, we decided why not just throw a single turbo on it. And then I personally have a 2007 335i. With upgraded twin turbos. And obviously the single turbo versus twin turbo upgrade is kind of a big topic and something that I think a lot of people struggle with, deciding which route to go when upgrading their BMW N54 engine. I know it's something that I spent multiple weeks mulling over and deciding which route I really wanted to go on my car. So hopefully in this video, we'll kind of cover some of the pros and cons of each setup, talk about cost, power goals, risks, all that good stuff. So hopefully this will give you guys a good starting point on deciding whether to go with the single turbo or the twin turbo upgrade for your 135 or 335i. So jumping right off, let's go ahead and start with cost, because obviously that's one of the biggest factors. If you want to upgrade your turbos, budget's going to be a big factor in that decision and how much you have to spend. Ultimately, these setups can end up costing about the same, but that depends on the starting point for your car. So if you have an N54 that's already full bolt-on, you already have the dual cone intakes, you already have downpipe upgrades, you already have inlets, outlets, so on and so forth, then generally going with a twin turbo upgrade is going to be the cheaper option. We'll get into specific costs here in just a moment. But just up front, if you're already starting with all the basic bolt-ons, twin turbos are generally going to be cheaper. Now, if you're starting with a clean slate or you have minimal modifications, maybe you just have a tune and an intake, then the single turbo can actually be a pretty comparable price to going the twin turbo route. So diving into specific costs here, generally for a quality single turbo kit, a top mount single turbo kit, you're going to end up spending about $4,000 to about $7,500. High-end kits like Dock Race, great single turbo kit, those are going to be a little bit on the higher end. So for those, you're going to be shelling out close to that $6,000 to $8,000 mark, which is pretty expensive for just a turbo upgrade, obviously. Of course, those are kits that come with the manifold and all the stuff to move the coolant expansion tank out of the way, intake, so on and so forth. So they are very complete kits, but still a pretty high point to start off if you're spending that much on a turbo kit, especially considering you're gonna need other mods like tuning, additional fueling like port injection. Speed Tech has a cast manifold top mount turbo kit for the N54. That's a fairly new offering, and that's actually what Jake decided to go with for the 135i behind me. Those kits are going to run about $4,000 to $4,500. So great starting point to get into a quality N54 single turbo kit. And again, that's going to come with the downpipe, the manifold, all that kind of stuff, intake. So if you don't have the basic bolt-ons, that's actually a very good price, considering downpipes are going to be a few hundred bucks and intake is $100. Inlets and outlets, stuff like that is expensive, and obviously you don't need those inlet and outlet upgrades with a single turbo. So right off the bat, if you don't have any mods on your N54, then a single turbo kit like that, the SpeedTech N54 kit for $4,000 is almost like buying twin turbo upgrades for $3,000, because when you get the twin turbo upgrades, you're still going to want to add downpipes, the dual cone intakes. You'll probably want inlets at the very least, and possibly outlets depending on the specific twin turbo upgrade you go for. But the good news is the twin turbo upgrades for a quality kit is generally going to run about $1,500 to $3,500. That depends on whether you're going with a stock frame TD03 turbo that's just basically, you know, a stock turbo bored out to accept larger internals, or a TD04, which is not using the stock housing, it's a larger turbo. Those are going to be on the higher end of the price range. We'll get into some more specific turbo offerings in a little bit and their rough price points. Ultimately, off the bat, just know for a single turbo kit, you're probably going to end up in that $4,000 to $7,000 ballpark, whereas a twin turbo kit's going to be about $1,500 to $3,500 on the very high end, but keep in mind, you'll need an extra roughly $1,000 in bolt-on upgrades if you don't already have all of that done. Diving right into pros and cons for the single turbo upgrade. The number one pro for a single turbo upgrade is really reliability, and that's especially true when you go with a top mount turbo kit. So these single turbo kits you're getting from huge turbo manufacturers, or the turbo is built by these huge turbo manufacturers like Garrett, Precision, BorgWarner. So big turbo companies that have been in the industry for a long time build quality turbo kits. Additionally, that turbo, when you get the top mount kit, is obviously right on the top of the engine bay. It's a couple bolts. You can pull that turbo right off the engine and slap a new one on if you, for whatever reason, run into a turbo failure, which is very rare with a lot of these upgraded turbos. Additionally, the top mount design means it's very easy to switch up your setup. Maybe initially you start with a smaller turbo, like a Precision 5862, and you decide down the road that you want a little more headroom and you want to turn things up a little bit, you can just go source a Precision 6466, for example, and bolt that right up with all the other parts in place. Very quick and easy job. Of course, you're going to have to go source that additional turbo, which will run about $1,500 or $2,000, but certainly convenient if you want to start small and turn things up in the future and switch up the turbo setup. It's very simple. Unlike twin turbos, where they're still in the stock location, you have to drop the subframe. Even for an experienced mechanic, it's probably an 8-hour job on the lower end, and for most people who don't have experience or shops charging book hours, they're gonna charge something like 15 to 18 hours of labor. So if you go with those twin turbos and they fail, or you just wanna switch out the setup, you realize that you got turbos that were smaller than your goals in the future, then that's a tedious job to switch those out. So certainly a pro for the single turbo there, especially the top mount kits. Another big pro for the single turbo is just the high-end potential, how much power you can make with a single turbo. The twin turbo options mostly max out around 650 to 700 wheel horsepower with the bigger TD04 turbo. Some people have made more power, but 650, anything above 650 is really starting to get out of the realm of twin turbos. Whereas with the big single turbo, if you get a turbo big enough, some people have made upwards and even a little bit beyond 1,000 wheel horsepower with a single turbo setup. So if you have big goals over 650, 700 wheel horsepower, then generally the single turbo is going to be the better route to go, since it can pretty easily achieve those numbers. Of course, with the right supporting mods and tuning. Anyway, the single turbos, and this is a little bit of a lengthier topic, single turbos are also a lot easier on the N54 engine, not just the N54, really any engine in general, moving from twin turbos to a single turbo. That single turbo setup is going to be a little bit easier on the engine. A couple of reasons for that. Number one, a lot of people talk about PSI boost pressure, but that's not everything when it comes to turbo upgrades or just turbo operation in general. CFM, the volume of airflow that the turbo is also moving, is very important in how much power you can make. So if you look at a bigger single turbo, say like a 6266, on 20 PSI, you can pretty easily make 550, 600 wheel horsepower just on 20 PSI. Compare that to, you know, the other extreme stock turbos. Stock turbos can make 20 PSI, but you're probably not going to get over 475 wheel horsepower with that. And same thing with the twin turbo upgrades. I have RB2s plus on my car, so they're TD03. I have inlets, outlets, so on and so forth. At 20 PSI, I'm probably not making much over 500 wheel horsepower. So basically, PSI for PSI, the single turbo, the larger single turbo, is going to make more power. And a lot of that just comes down to the higher CFM, the higher volume and efficiency that turbo is moving the air throughout the engine. And so obviously lower boost is going to be a little bit easier on the engine right off the bat. On top of that, you look at these single turbos, they have slightly higher boost thresholds and slightly longer turbo spools, so they're not making quite as much low-end torque as twin turbo upgrades. And the benefit of that is the lower in the RPM range you make a certain power or torque or boost, you're subjecting the cylinders to higher pressures for longer periods, since the pistons are moving a little slower at lower RPMs, which increases the chance of running into detonation and knock, which obviously is a big killer of these engines, especially when you're starting to push up into that 600 plus wheel horsepower territory. So the single turbos are a little bit easier for multiple reasons. There's a couple other things that we could get into, but that would take a lot of time to cover. But ultimately the point is, a single turbo at a given power level or a given boost level is going to be easier and safer for the engine than a twin turbo setup running the same boost or the same power. Lastly, the benefit with the single turbo, and this is subjective, but I think a lot of people tend to agree with this, is single turbo N54s simply sound a lot better than twin turbo N54s. That's certainly true in my opinion. Again, my 335i has upgraded twin turbos. I think it sounds great, but I don't think it sounds as good as the single turbo N54. So something that's subjective, but certainly another nod to another pro for the single turbo in most people's eyes. So moving on to some pros of the twin turbo setup now, obviously, one of the biggest pros is going to be that quicker spool, especially if you go with a stock frame TD03 turbo, you're going to get much more of an OEM feel. Now, of course, you have larger internals in there, so it is going to introduce a little bit more turbo lag, as well as a slightly higher boost threshold. And when I say boost threshold, that's really talking about the RPMs needed to achieve max boost with the turbo. So obviously, as you get a larger turbo, you need more RPMs, you need more exhaust gas flow over the turbine to make your peak boost. So going with larger twin turbos is going to add a little bit of turbo lag and a slightly higher boost threshold, but it's not as drastic as single turbos. As a quick side note, single turbos actually can and do spool very well on the N54. Thanks to the Vanos, with proper tuning, you can get those things spooling very well. But still, that boost threshold is really the biggest thing. You're just going to need more RPMs with a larger single turbo. And the same thing applies for larger TD04 twins. But if you're sticking with that stock housing, you're going to get much more of an OEM feel. And so you're still going to have plenty of boost and torque and passing power, you know, simply downshifting one gear or not even downshifting at all, just being in, you know, six gear on the highway at 70 miles an hour. Whereas with the big single turbo setup, you're generally going to need a couple extra RPMs, you know, an extra 500 or 1,000 RPMs. So that could be the difference in downshifting or, you know, downshifting an extra gear just to get above that boost threshold and be able to kind of quickly build that boost for passing power. But anyway, that certainly is a pro for the twin turbos, and something that I enjoy with my 335i is not needing to constantly downshift to get up to that, you know, 3,000, 4,000 RPM mark. If I hit the gas at 2,500 RPM, there's still plenty of boost, plenty of power and torque on tap pretty quickly. Another pro of the twin turbos is if you already have most of the basic bolt-ons, the twin turbos are gonna be significantly cheaper, especially if you just want a modest upgrade, like say the RB1s, for example, which can make about 500 wheel horsepower, and those I think are right around that $1,500 price point. So obviously a very kind of cheap entry price for those twin turbos, and certainly an advantage of the twins over the single turbo, especially if you just want kind of a modest conservative setup. The twin turbos are going to be much cheaper. And again, already kind of touched on my third little bullet here with the quicker turbo spool is the twin turbos are just going to feel a little more natural. It's going to be kind of what you're used to from a stock turbo N54 in the sense that you just have plenty of that low-end torque available on tap, even in higher gears, whereas the single turbo is going to require a bit more downshifting. Moving to the cons for these turbo setups, for the single turbo, again, just the opposite of the twin turbos, it's going to be a little bit pricier to get into up front, especially if you already have the bolt-ons and you have to remove all of that and either try to sell it, you know, half the price used, or just throw it away or keep it stored in the garage, whatever the case. You're going to be spending a bit more up front to get that single turbo kit. And then again, just the opposite of the twin turbo pros, the single turbos are going to have a little bit more turbo lag and a higher boost threshold. Again, I touched on this briefly. They can still spool very well. It's hard to explain in words, but you can kind of check out some videos and see that an N54 with the big single turbo will still spool very well, especially if you're starting at, you know, 4,000 or 5,000 RPMs. That turbo is going to get up to peak boost pretty quickly. It's just the main thing, again, comes down to that boost threshold, where if you give it a lot of throttle at 2,000 RPMs, that turbo's just not gonna be able to build very much boost at all. Cons for the twin turbo setup. The labor, which again, already touched on this briefly, but the labor is a pain in the ass. You have to drop the subframe, experienced mechanics, it takes a while for them. If you're just doing it at home in your garage, it's probably gonna take you 15 plus hours. If you've never done it before and don't have much experience, you might even spend 20 plus hours getting those upgraded twin turbos in there. And again, if they fail, run into any issues, you want to switch out the turbo setup, you're going to have to do all of that labor all over again versus a single turbo, which you just pop it off with a couple bolts and throw a new turbo on there. So certainly a downside with the N54 turbos. Back in the day, that was a bigger downside because a lot of these companies that were making these twin turbo upgrades were still kind of learning and figuring things out. So they weren't quite as reliable 5, 8, 10 years ago. But nowadays, a lot of these twin turbo offerings, Vargas, RB turbos, pure turbos, etc., are pretty reliable and don't very often run into failures. Again, a little bit harder on the engine and the power potential just isn't quite as high. If you're shooting for anything over 650 wheel horsepower, I would go ahead and say just eliminate the twin turbos right off the bat. Again, there are a couple options like the RB game finisher high flow turbos, which can make pretty close to 700 wheel horsepower, if not even more than that, if you went for a really max effort setup. So they can do it, but if you want to build in that extra headroom, I'd say anything over 650 wheel horsepower, just cross the twin turbos off the list and start looking for single turbos. Those are really the biggest cons of the twin turbos. Again, harder on the engine, lower power potential, and the labor and swapping them out is just kind of a challenge. So ultimately, in summary, you know, the right route really depends on your personal preferences and goals. Part of the reason I went with the twin turbos on my 335i is I knew I never really wanted to push much beyond the 550 wheel horsepower ballpark. And I personally believe the N54, anything under 600 wheel horsepower, anything really under kind of 575 is a good ballpark for twin turbos. And I just felt like a single turbo setup was a little overkill for what I needed. And the twin turbos were going to get the job done for cheaper and have more of that OEM performance and feel with the low end torque and spool. So anything 450 to 550 wheel horsepower, I think the twin turbos are a great option. Once you get into that 550 to 650 wheel horsepower ballpark is where it's really a toss up. And that comes down much more to personal preference. Both turbos with the right turbo setup can easily achieve those goals. So that just depends on what you value, sounds, how easy it is on the engine, all of those pros and cons that we just covered a moment ago. And then again, as I briefly touched on, anything over 650 wheel horsepower, I would personally just eliminate the twin turbo setups, especially if you want over 750 wheel horsepower. That's getting into territory that very few twin turbo setups have ever achieved. Yeah, you can still do the twin turbos at, you know, 650, 750 wheel horsepower, 650 to 700 wheel horsepower, but I just don't think it's the best setup for the N54 at those power levels, especially since that's starting to push into territory where you're really putting the engine at risk. And again, the single turbo is going to be easier on the engine. Well, ultimately, that's all we have. Sorry for the lengthy video here. There is quite a bit to say about N54 single and twin turbos. I'll go ahead and cut myself off here before I continue chatting. But as one final note, we'll have more content coming in the future since we will soon have both the single turbo and twin turbo N54s up and running. So we'll have plenty more content coming for that in the future. If you guys like the video, please hit that like button, smash subscribe button, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the BMW N54. Thanks, guys.